In this example, we're going to solve a system of equations by graphing. And I'm going ahead and letting you know that this system does not have a solution. And I want to show you how that looks as you're solving the problem. So just like you would any other system, go ahead and take that first line, write it down, and solve for y. So you're looking at the equal sign, realizing that you have to move that negative 5x by adding it. And when you do, you're going to have 4y equals 5x plus 16, writing the x first and the 16 second. Then you're going to notice that you have to divide by the 4 in front of the y, so go ahead and do that all three places, and that leaves you with y equals 5/4 x plus 4, because 16 divided by 4 is 4. That gives us our y-intercept that we can plot on the graph at 0, 4, and the slope gives us a map for that second point. A slope of 5 over 4 tells us to go up 5 and right 4 to place a second point. And you can go ahead and draw a line through those points and label your line y equals 5/4 x plus 4. We're going ahead and using our modified label, our y equals mx plus b label, so that you can see how the slopes end up on this particular example. So let's take the second line, write that one down, and we're going to solve for y. What I notice on this line is the y is on the right-hand side of the equal sign. So you can just swap the sides. Write your negative 8y on the left-hand side and put the 24 minus 10x on the right-hand side. Doesn't change anything. When I look at the equal sign, I'm noticing on the right-hand side that my x term doesn't come first. So I'm going to fix that and write negative 8y equals negative 10x plus 24, just swapping that around and getting ready for my y equals mx plus b format. Divide by the negative 8 in all three spots, and when you simplify, you will have y equals 5/4 x minus 3. The negative 10 over negative 8 simplifies to positive 5 over 4, and the 24 divided by negative 8 gives you negative 3. So this gives us a y-intercept of 0, negative 3. Go ahead and plot that on your graph. Look at the slope. It's telling us to go up 5 and right 4, so plot a second point and draw a line through that point, labeling that line y equals 5/4 x minus 3. Now take a look at your two labels and notice that your slopes are both 5 over 4. So for parallel lines, those slopes are the same slopes. Also, in those lines, you'll notice the intercepts are different numbers. That means they fall in different spots on the graph itself. So, same slopes, but different intercepts. When you see this scenario, you're going to think to yourself, okay, this is parallel, these are parallel lines, which means if I extend them, they're never going to touch. And if they never touch, they don't have a solution. So, when you are answering this type of problem, you're just going to write or circle no solution, and that will be your final answer.